Hello, welcome to Reptile Ridge. In this webisode, we're going to explore the secret world of serpents. Starting with this small water snake, basking on a partially submerged log. It's a species of water snake, but it's so far out there, I can't make a positive ID. It's small, maybe 2 feet in length, with wide, dark stripes against a reddish-brown or rust-colored body. A beautiful little snake. And here, I find an interesting turtle. It's a small Alabama map turtle, a common species found along the Gulf Coast, in rivers, lakes, and of course the swamp. It's a windy early afternoon in mid-April, the breeding season for the reptiles of the River Ridge. A great time of year to go looking for various species. Again, I find another common water snake. This beautiful creature is a yellow-bellied water snake, named for that pretty, bright yellow belly. The top of the body of the snake is a dark olive to brown in color. This one is a lovely shade of olive green. A non-venomous species, harmless to humans. They eat a diet of small fish, frogs, insects, and sometimes small birds and their eggs. This one's pretty big, 3 to 4 feet long. It's hard to tell when they're not completely stretched out. A small painted turtle rests on a log. Then, I hear a high-pitched cry above me. It sounded like the cries of a small kitten. I pan up and down the tree, searching for the source of the cries. Then, I see movement. It's a frog. At first, it appears to be tangled in a vine. Then, as I zoom in, I can clearly see this is no vine. It's a small snake, and it's got a death grip on this poor little frog. It looks like a garter snake or a ribbon snake. It has the frog by its front leg. Wow, that's a big frog for such a tiny snake. The snake can be no more than 2 feet long, if that. Don't be fooled. A snake has the ability to unhinge its jaws. The skin can stretch to accommodate the prey. My heart sinks for this poor little frog as it struggles for its life. I also have to stop and admire the hunting skills of the snake. I'm not sure of the exact species of the frog, but it is some type of tree frog. It was unfortunately sleeping in the trunk of the tree. The snake found it and caught it off guard. Now it seems certain this snake will have a meal that will sustain it for weeks. The tiny snake contracts its muscles, forcing the frog further into its mouth. Watch carefully. You'll see the snake now has the frog's shoulder in its mouth. The head will follow. This frog will die a slow, torturous death. Since small arboreal snakes in this area are non-venomous, they rely on constriction or squeezing their prey to death. Or, as this one is doing, eating their catch alive. You can clearly see the snake's jaws, unhinged, and the skin slowly slipping over the frog's head. The frog is still very much alive, right now. Movement in the branches of a nearby tree catches my eye. It's a large male anole. Today, he is thanking his lucky stars that it wasn't him caught in the serpent's lair. Along with frogs, anoles, and small birds, like this one, are on the snake's menu. Today, however, the bird and the anole will live to see another day. Sadly, I don't think that's going to hold true for the little frog. It's going to take this snake hours to completely devour its meal, something I just don't have. I need to get out of here. The swamp is no place to be caught after dark, with only a camera for protection. Back home, I check in with the resident anoles. The first one I see is Orion, stretched out basking on a small limb. About 15 feet away, I see another. I look back over to see what Orion is doing. He's on full alert. He spotted the other anole. Anoles have excellent vision. They have to in order to survive the wild. I put my attention on the unknown male. Then I spot another one. Down below him, it looks like a female. Territorial aggression and testosterone are raging. These two males, one with only half a tail, are about to engage in battle. The two warring anoles will fight for their right, the right to mate with that female. Please be sure to join me and these guys next time for one of the best anole battles yet. Oh, it's gonna be good. See you next time.